And if we lay it out graphically, it looks like a pipe and filters. The filters are the components along the way, and the pipes are the little lines connecting them. And this form will indeed solve the problem, and yet it's much different than the previous form. Well, Parnas also laid out two other solutions, which I want to briefly describe to you, and there are probably many more.
Is there a problem necessarily, because the pipe and filter doesn't have any central storage location, that we're not keeping that data? Do we need to have good like logging systems, for instance, if we use that type of approach, because the data isn't persistent maybe like it would be with a shared data model?
Well, okay, so I haven't really laid out what the requirements of the problem are, okay? And even in the shared data solution, that's in memory and it's going to go away when the process is over. Now, we could imagine adding in or being more explicit about what the requirements are and whether we need to persist them, okay? And let's come back to that in a couple minutes.
Okay.
Okay? First, I'd like to go over a couple of other solutions that Parnas proposes. The next one to consider is called the abstract data type, or ADT, solution. And this is breaking the system into components based upon important data structures. So when we had the shared memory solution, that was breaking things into components based upon functions, and likewise the pipe and filter was more breaking it into functions. Here we're thinking in terms of the data first. We're going to hide the representations of those data behind abstract interfaces. That is, we have a function call interface to it, and how exactly we store the stuff away is all hidden from the other components. The components holding the data, of course, are also going to have some operations available to them. In a sense, this is a precursor to an object-oriented approach. It was first developed before object-oriented languages became popular, but many of the features that ADTs have been incorporated into object-oriented solutions to things.